persistent symptoms in Lyme disease and in the long haulers are remarkably similar. There seems to be this trio of symptoms that are linked and travel together in both of these illnesses and similarly in chronic fatigue syndrome and even fibromyalgia. And these three symptoms are very characteristic. They include fatigue. And by fatigue, I mean severe fatigue, not just the mild fatigue of everyday living, but kind of disabling fatigue. The second symptom are in the cognitive symptom realm, and those are memory problems, difficulty focusing, and multitasking. And then the third type of symptoms are pain type symptoms involving either the musculoskeletal system or sometimes the nerves, but it are the pain type of symptoms. It was striking when I first saw the display of the symptoms in the COVID long haulers. They were displayed on a graph where each line in the graph was one of the symptoms and they formed kind of a pattern. And when you take that pattern in the COVID long haulers and put it next to the pattern of the Lyme persistent symptom group, they're almost identical. It almost makes like a butterfly of symmetry of the distribution of the symptoms. Again, at the top are those core symptoms, fatigue, cognitive symptoms, pain, and they almost parallel each other exactly in the two illnesses. The COVID long haulers on one side, the persistent Lyme group on the other side. It's remarkable. So there is a difference. Lots of lung symptoms in the COVID patients and then also the COVID long haulers. So things like breathlessness and trouble breathing, where in the Lyme disease group, you don't see that because the initial infection doesn't really involve the lungs. One of the lessons that the long-haul Lyme patients, those with these prolonged persistent symptoms, one of the lessons that the Lyme disease patients taught us is that these patients are often misunderstood and not heard. Their illness really has a huge impact on their life. We learned that in Lyme disease. We're hoping the same thing doesn't happen in the COVID long haulers. In fact, Allison Redman and I from our research group published a letter to the editor of Lancet, pointing out the similarities in how the long hauler patients were not being believed and how we shouldn't subject that on those patients, because we learned from Lyme disease that harms the patients even more. They're already sick, but then if they're not believed, that's insult to injury. There's potential multiple mechanisms that's driving those symptoms. In other words, this is a very heterogeneous group of patients. Some of the patients have more prominent pain, some have more prominent fatigue, some have more prominent cognitive symptoms. And we think about what drives them in similarly in different realms. For instance, one thing driving the symptoms may be persistent infection, or at least persistent elements of infection, parts of the bacteria or virus. The second thing driving the symptoms may be the host human inflammatory response responding to those antigens or bacteria, or independent, i.e. autoimmunity. And then a third component in this kind of, we call it this Venn diagram of causes, could be alterations in brain physiology. We've done studies showing that on PET imaging of the brain, that the actual cells in the brain are activated in the Lyme disease patients, and they're activated probably because they're inflamed. When the brain gets inflamed, even if it's not due to direct infection, inflammation in the brain are not a good combination. It alters the way the brain works, the way it connects, the way it functions. And so we kind of have these three things that are probably working, sometimes all in concert: the infection, the inflammatory response, and then the impact on the brain. Mm-hmm. One of the things we're learning from the COVID long haulers is they have a very high percentage are suffering from symptoms that may be traced back to dysfunction of the autonomic nervous system. One specific dysfunction has to do with control of their heart rate and blood pressure and an illness called POTS, which stands for postural orthostatic tachycardia syndrome. They're seeing that much more commonly in the COVID long haulers. And what this does is it causes abnormalities in pulse and blood pressure. And when that happens, that contributes to symptoms like fatigue and lightheadedness and implies that something going on in the COVID long haulers has caused dysregulation or illness in their autonomic nervous system. Thinking back about it, we started to think about that in our Lyme disease patients, and similarly, to lesser extent, but similarly, we've seen that in those patients as well. Chronic fatigue, the same story, a lot of autonomic symptoms. So this may be, again, another common theme that's going to emerge, is that one of the mechanisms of symptoms may have to do with this autonomic nervous system dysfunction. Discoveries in COVID may be able to be translated to the Lyme disease arena, also to the chronic fatigue arena, and they may come much more quickly now that there's so much attention and money being put into the COVID research. So the Lyme Disease Research Center is very excited now to be involved in COVID research as well. We have this great opportunity to look at the mechanisms of our Lyme disease long hauler patients and compare them to the COVID long haulers. So it's a really unique opportunity to take the work we've been doing and now place it side by side with investigators at Hopkins, taking some of the lessons we've already learned in Lyme disease and using those and putting them together to try to find answers.